Hello everyone, welcome back with Rhinoceros Basic 3D Modeling Tutorial for exercise number 2. Okay, in here I will use a top view, you can click it, and I will change into maximize. The next, I will create a rectangle object from 3 points, click in here, and I will move to the bottom, you can set into 92, you can click. Then move for the bracket, I will set into 142, click again. In here, I will create circle. You can click here, circle. Start from this counter point. And I will set radius into 8. You can tap, press enter. And now we can move this object. You can tap move. And select this circle object. You can move to drag it. I will set into 21. Okay, we move again this object to the bottom, 21. In here, I will use mirror command. You can tap mirror. Press enter, select this circle. I will mirror from middle point or center point to the top. We mirror again this two circle from center point to the left here. Okay, you can use fillet command. Don't forget to set a radius into 10. You can tap R and tap 10 to change radius into 10. You can click at this corner. We fillet again in here. Next at this point and then in here. Okay, now I will use extrude command to convert this object into 3D. You can click the perspective tab, and in here I will use extrude, press enter, select this object, that is all object, enter again. We can extrude to the top about 14, press enter. Now you can change into set for visual style, so we have this simple 3D object. The next, I will create a simple rectangle object with 3 points. You can click here, and I will click in it. Move into this direction. We can set into 92. Click, and for width we can set into 15. Click again. I will use a rotate command to rotate this object. You can tap rotate. Press enter, select the object, enter again. Don't forget to change copy into yes. You can tap C, enter this for no, and C again this for yes. So you can rotate from center point. Okay, I will rotate into 90 degree. You can click and press enter to apply. The next, I will use a trim command. Okay, to cut this line. Press enter with enter again. Select these two objects, press enter, and we cut in here. Okay, the next you can use a join command to combine these all objects into one. Okay, now we can move this object into center point in here. You can use a move tool. You can tap move, press enter, select this object. Okay, enter again. We can move from center point, and we can move from center point in here. You can sort at this point, middle point, and move to center point. Okay. The next, I will use extrusion tools to extrude this object. Okay, you can tap extrude, select the object, press enter. We extrude to the top into 40, press enter. Now we can combine between these two objects. You can use this tool, boolean union. Select this object and this object, press enter. So it will be combined into one. In here, I will create circle from this center point. Okay, you can click it, circle. Click at this point, okay, center point. And move into here, or you can set with a radius 31. Okay, this for radius 31, press enter. Don't forget to chamfer at this edge. You can use a chamfer edge. Okay, we choose here chamfer edge, and for this stand you can tap N. We can set this stand into 15 and also 15 for chamfer. You can select at this edge. Okay, next you can press enter to chamfer. Now for the circle, we can use extrude tool. Extrude the circle to the top. We can set into 20. Press enter. I will change into front view, and we can move this object and select move or tap move, press enter, select this object. From this point to the bottom, I will set into 10. Enter again. Click, and then I will go to perspective option. In here we can use boolean again, and I will combine between these two objects. Enter. Okay, we create circle in center point in here. You can click here, circle. And I will start from center point. I will set the radius into 20. And you can use extrude tools to extrude this circle object to the top. You can set into 30. Press enter. And forget to combine between this object. Okay. Last, we create circle from center point. And I will set the radius into 10. Next, you can use extrude tools to extrude this circle. To the bottom here, we can set into 70. Now, to create holes, we can use this tool, boolean difference. You can click at this drop down menu, choose this option, boolean difference, select this object, and enter, and click at this object, enter again. So it will be create holes. For the next, we can use a fillet edge command. You can tap fillet edge, click here, and set a radius into 2. You can tap N, tap 2 for radius, and you can click at this edge also in here. Next, at this point, and then in here, you can press right mouse to use pen and orbit tools. Okay. If you done, you can press enter and enter again to apply. So we already create this simple 3D models for exercise number 2 with Rhinoceros software. And if you have any question about this tutorial, you can comment below this video.